Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear.
Clyde said we could remove his name from the bulletin, that he's doing well. We rejoice. Question was raised about Helen Warren. That's Darlene's sister-in-law. Helen had fallen and broken her hip, and she's doing well. We rejoice with that. Down at near the bottom of the first column, Jacob Steele. He's got some real health issues and needs prayers, concerned about some upcoming results and whatnot. In the second column, Bill Thrasher has got a good report from the doctor that the cancer has not spread. We're grateful for that. Halfway down the second column, Justin Gardner is back to normal, eating food. He was the guy that couldn't eat for like 6 weeks, and he's doing well. We rejoice. Five names from the bottom of the second column. Sheila Osman on Thursday is going to have a kidney stone that's broken up. Dolores Johnson right under her. Dolores Johnson usually is at her church. She's going to get home from the hospital today. She's been in rehab over Trinity East, and we're grateful that she's going to get home. And then some additional names. Marcia Smith, is she making progress with her pneumonia? No. Okay, she had COVID and got over the COVID, but now has pneumonia.
Yeah.
And so we need to pray for Marcia Smith. It's
and Tom,
Sherry.
My son-in-law.
Yes. Paul Stanley. Mm-hmm.
It looks like he's going to have to go on a heart transplant.
Oh, my goodness.
And my brother-in-law is in stage 3 colon cancer. Again, this is his third bout with cancer.
And your brother-in-law, his name is?
Alan Crawford.
Okay, Alan Crawford.
Tim Ramona Clopton.
Yes, sir. Ramona Clopton.
She's got a sister-in-law.
Mm-hmm, has some health issues. And we'll pray for Alan Crawford and certainly Tom Stanley with needing a heart transplant and your daughter, Marcia Smith. John Knight, this is an uncle of a friend of April's. He was burned badly this past week and needs. He was going into a facility and an oxygen tank was leaking that they didn't realize. And something ignited the oxygen tank and he got burned very badly. Ramona Clopton has got some health issues, Chuck and Bessie's relative.
She had a stroke.
She had a stroke. Okay. And then Alex Hutchinson, a friend of Sheila's that has cancer, that the cancer is spreading. And pray that the Lord will have mercy. And then we've got under grieving families, and I wanted to mention this. It's good to have Barbara Gill with us this morning. Sadly, last week she wasn't here. She wasn't feeling well. Her sister suddenly passed away last Sunday in her sleep. 69 years of age, had recently been to the doctor, got a clean bill of health. And her husband let her sleep in and went in to check on her, and she passed away. So our deepest sympathy. You'll see sitting next to her, Gary Delaney. Gary was with us last week. And Gary's daughter, Darla. Darla is Barbara's daughter-in-law. But Gary and Darla, well, Gary lost his wife, Darla's mom, about a month ago. And it's good to have them with us this morning. And it's good to see all the rest of you here, too. Thank you for being here. Are there additional names or needs that you'd like to bring our attention? Yes, sure.
I'm member Sandra Nemeth. She's okay. A member here. She's having quite a bit of problem with her legs. We were over visiting with her last night. She's
can't just use the cane, and she just, she says she's sick all the time, and I don't want her to give up, but.
It's discouraging when you're constantly battling health issues, and yes, pray for Sandra Nemeth. She had a couple falls this past year that were really bad, and so they're trying to exercise utmost caution. But do keep her in your thoughts and prayers. I started to say about Dolores Johnson, she's been telling family, she's told me when I've gone to visit her, just pray the Lord takes me home. She's just kind of discouraged. But maybe there are additional names or needs you'd like to mention. Thank you, Cheryl and Donna, for mentioning that. Any others? Well, let's pray together. Father, we've come to your house today, and we're grateful that we can be here. As we go through a prayer list, Father, it's a reminder to us of how blessed we are. So many people that have very serious health concerns. And Father, we come to you and we ask for your blessing upon them. We're thankful again for our health. We're thankful for this place to come to. We're thankful for the freedom that we have to come. We're thankful, Father, for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, that through faith in him, we're saved. We're thankful, Father, for your Spirit who lives within our hearts and gives us the assurance every day that not only we belong to you, but gives us your instruction. We just thank you, Father, for all that you do. And we come before you because we recognize that you can help us. We're thankful for answers to prayer. We're grateful that Clyde is doing so much better. So thankful that Dolores is going to get to come back home. Thankful that Barbara got over her sickness from last week. Father, there's many times we've seen your hand at work touching us and helping us well and get well. And we just pray that you do the same for all of these others. There are a lot of different names and needs. And Father, we're just looking to you and asking that you'd have mercy upon them and touch them and heal them and restore them to health and strength. Father, if you decide not to, we pray that you grant us the grace to continue to trust. We don't want to see our loved ones taken from us. I know that I still miss my mom and I miss my younger brother. But Father, we know that you've got a purpose in all things. And if you decide to take a loved one, we pray that you might grant us the ability to continue to trust and recognize that you know what's best. We pray, Father, that you'd have mercy and allow our loved ones to get better and enable them to stay here with us. We do pray, Father, that you'd even be with unspoken needs, those things that are on our heart that we're not talking about with others. We pray that you might help us at this time to know that you're there and that you understand and you're going to work to get those things worked out. We do pray, Father, for our country. We pray for our leaders that, Lord, you would please give them wisdom, help them to pass laws that are honoring to you. We pray that you would help us as Christians to stand up for what is right, especially in a time in which it's very discouraging. It seems like that, as the sign down the road at the Church of Christ says, woe to those who call good evil and those who call evil good. And Father, we see that all the time, but help us to remember we need to stand up for what is right and speak up and pray, Father, that you will bless what we do and what we have to say, that your word might be honored. We do pray, Father, there could be a revival within churches, that, Father, your Spirit might move in the hearts of your people, and that we would understand that we really need more time with you, not less. Pray, Father, that there could be a turning back to you. We pray, Father, for those that are lost, that they could come under conviction and recognize that they need to get saved before it's too late. Father, we continue to pray for our military and law enforcement, that you'll keep them safe. And we do pray that this morning as we get ready to go through the service here, that you'll bless the message here, but also bless in the back as ladies work with the kids. And pray, Father, that you will help these kids to realize how vitally important it is that they stay connected to you. We're so thankful for children. And Father, we realize it is a very dangerous world that they're entering, and they will definitely need your word to guide them. So, Father, we come seeking your blessing. Thanking you for being our God. Just now use the remainder of this time for your glory. May you be honored. For Jesus' sake, in whose name we pray.